BMW Fanatic. In this video, I'm going to show you just how to troubleshoot a misfire and fix it on your BMW. Now, it usually does pinpoint to a certain specific part, but you want to make sure before you start buying parts that you are fixing the problem. The last thing I try to tell anybody is start buying parts without having a root cause, meaning like you know exactly what's failing, because 9 out of 10 times, there are BMW owners that will just start buying all random parts because they think what's wrong with it without confirming what's wrong with it. So in this video, I'm gonna show you just that. So for illustration purposes, you're gonna have a coil, 6 total, right? Just gonna lay out all these coils. So you have all 6 coils here. Now let's say you have a misfire on cylinder number 1. So it's gonna be 1 through 6. Cylinder number 1, okay? You take off your engine cover, you follow my DIY, I'll post that up here at the top, how to change your spark plugs and coils. So that way you know to take everything off and how to do everything and get the proper tools that you need for that. But this is something that you can do without buying anything. So if you have a cylinder 1 misfire, you're going to, after you take the cover off, you're gonna take cylinder number 1, being the easy one, being the coil, and you're gonna swap it with cylinder number 2. You're gonna swap it like that. Now remind you that you're gonna need to delete that code on there, so that way you start fresh, okay? Delete it, then you did the little swap. You're gonna start your car up yet again, and you're gonna see if the cylinder number 1 misfire follows to cylinder number 2. If it is cylinder number 2, like if it follows, then you know you have a bad coil. So you wanna go ahead and buy a new coil and throw this one away. Let's say cylinder number 1 does not transfer to cylinder number 2 as far as the misfire. Let's say you still have it in cylinder number 1. The next easy thing to do, depending on how old your spark plugs are, is to go ahead and replace the cylinder number 1 plug, and really it's best to just replace all 6. You know, being, you know, $40 to $80, give or take where you get it from and the price range of everything, it's very inexpensive to do all 6. Now you're going to want to do all 6 spark plugs if you're tuned in 54 every like 12-15,000 miles, just to keep up on it so you do not have a misfire. So when you're pulling out cylinder number 1 spark plug, here's another good thing to test, to see. If it has fuel on the spark plug, then you know it's a leaky injector, your cylinder number 1 injector, and you know right off the bat, your injector is causing your misfire. But let's say the plug isn't wet with fuel, and you're still having the issue. Still go towards the injector being at fault, because you know, that injector may not be leaking, but it may not be spraying correctly, and therefore it can't keep up and it's gonna, you know, still cause a misfire. That's exactly the same thing that happened to me on that, and I still had a misfire, even though all my plugs looked perfectly fine. Another good test as far as everything, let's say it's just not one cylinder, it's multiple cylinders. Now you'll have a code for multiple cylinders to do that. So what you can do is go ahead and start flip-flopping one at a time to see if it follows. You may have one that follows, and you may have others that do not follow. So it's gonna take a lot of diagnosing to see, okay, you know, is it the plugs? Is it one of the coils? Is it all the coils? Is it the injectors? Is it only one injector? Is it all the injectors? So it's a lot of back and forth to try to troubleshoot it, but you're troubleshooting it before technically replacing anything. And that's the biggest thing, is that you want to make sure. Now, O2 sensors will cause misfires as well. Now you should have an O2 code coming up. Now, the biggest thing I cannot stress enough, guys, is that you need to be able to have a proper BMW scan tool, so that way you can check all codes that are out there. Now, sometimes you'll have shadow fault codes and then you'll have your current codes, but with having that good BMW scan tool, you can start going through all the many different systems of your DME and what's displaying out there. So that way you can see, is it truly an injector, or is it truly this or something else like that? I've been using the Barbarian test
Technic scan tool, which does data logging. Now, you can do this with the JB4 and also MHD, doing some data logging to check all the different parameters of how your car is operating. This will just ensure that, you know, you can drill down to that root cause and basically say, yes, you know, it's an injector, or it's one injector, or it's all injectors. So that way you have peace of mind when you're buying those replacement parts. Now, like I said, when I had injector issues, I was having more of a stutter as far as starting up, but I did have fuel mixture codes that came up. My plugs are still dry, but the fuel mixture codes was obviously a clear indication, since I wasn't running any E85 at that time, that it was a clear shot for the injectors. Now, injectors fail way too often. It's truly something that is very important to your car and something that you should probably replace if you're in that higher mileage mark and you plan on keeping your car, and also if you have an older indexes on your injectors. So you want to be able to make sure to check those indexes to see where you stand as far as your car goes. Outside of all that, a proper BMW scan tool, you know, is going to be your clear winner. Please read your codes, please check things, do this swapping back and forth, so that way you can really identify at your true root cause before you start replacing any parts. Well guys, thanks for stopping in today, and as always, please be sure to subscribe, smash that like button, and comment below. Take care, and best of luck to getting your car all up to par as far as maintenance wise.